From a consultancy perspective, are you an AV consultant or are you an IT consultant?
I would say I'm neither. I'd actually say I'm a business consultant that understands the customers and what the customers need and what the customer's trying to achieve. And then from that, linking the AV and the IT and telecoms and other areas together, because there are lots of commonalities between the two. But going back to your question, if you were asked to say, is it AV or IT? I'd say IT first with AV.
Why? Surely AV is the effect you're trying to deliver, and IT is a facilitator, isn't it?
It is, but the issue you've got is the screen that hangs on the wall needs to be fed with content. What that content is, how it gets across the network, how it's managed across a network. And that network could be as simple as in one room. It doesn't necessarily mean to say it's a whole, you know, around a whole building, but it comes across those networks. And the screen goes at the end. The screen, if you like, is an enabler in that environment.
But the content is the core, isn't it, surely?
Content's the core, but the content is actually driven from the front end. Again, it's like when people talk about digital signage, and they go on about the screens and the screen, how you can interact with the screen. What's the content? Why are you putting the content? How do you interact with that content? Where's that content being fed from? Locally, of a hard drive, or is it in the cloud? All these different things. So you've got to link it all together. So rather than just being IT and AV, it is a combination of both. But understanding how that's actually done is critical at the front end.
So when you're brought into an assignment, does the consultant have to understand about the particular business that client's in, or are they brought in from what we would call IT applications that have a bit of AV thrown in?
The consultancy that I do tends to be from a business perspective, first of all. That's the way I position myself, because I'm going to be, if I go into something, I'll be making assumptions on what that client needs. And a lot of people still do that, for manufacturers and consultancies as well. If you make assumptions, you're probably going to get it wrong. So the first, before you even go in, is find out information about that customer. And I'll get an example on that. When I was working in Saudi Telecoms, I was told by a very large consultancy global company that they had no advertising. They didn't do anything. I stopped the meeting. I said, give me a few minutes. They said, what? I said, give me 15 minutes. 15 minutes, I went back in. I said, so this organization you've been dealing with, supplying millions of pounds worth of systems, don't do any advertising, no marketing, no nothing. These are all the adverts and awards they've won for advertising. Do you fly into Riyadh and the airport, King Khaled Airport? Yeah. This is what you see when you walk into the arrivals hall. It's all there. Have you ever noticed it? So you can't turn around and say, don't do anything. I said, it's easier to find out information about the customers. It's out there. Before you walk into a university and you're talking to the people at university, they love talking about themselves. It's on their website, what their goals are, what their aspirations are. So you have a feeling and a view of what they're trying to achieve before you get there.
So clients expect that, do they?
Well, I don't think clients actually expect it. From some people, with me, it's just an everyday item. I'm just used to doing it. And when you walk in and you actually, suddenly you build that rapport up with that customer because you understand what they're trying to achieve. You understand where they're trying to go. And then you can work with them and actually help them to achieve those goals. And there's consultancy I've done in the past where As a consultancy, I was working as a systems integrator, but turned into sort of consultancy with the client, where nobody had actually understood what they were trying to achieve. And it was a simple thing. They called one of their rooms the Harvard suite, which had most of the technology going in. The question I asked them was, I said to the lady running the whole lot, I said, can I just ask you a quick question? Call it a Harvard suite. Can I assume you're linking with, because it was a business school, are you linking with Harvard University? And he said, well, about time Sunday actually understood what we were trying to achieve. I said, well, it made sense to me. It was called the Harvard suite. Why would you call it that? So it was taking the consultancy, if you like, to a different level, understanding their business. It does make it a lot easier with people when you do that, a lot easier, because they feel comfortable that you're not trying to sell them a product, you're not trying to sell them a service, you understand what their issues are.
How do customers evaluate consultants? Is it straightforward shootout, or is it a much more sophisticated process?
Depends on the client, it varies, and depends on the type of customer and whether they've used consultants in the past. You may find some customers who actually have had a bad experience in consultancy, where they've had a project where somebody's just dusted off something in the past and said, well, that'll do you. And they've had a bad experience when they actually come to use it. It doesn't do what they want it to do. That's if they know what they wanted to do in the first place. You get other ones that actually know people, want to bring the right people in, and actually say, I'll hand it over to you, you look after it. Yeah.
So if someone's going to employ you, what questions would you expect them to ask you?
What's my background? What have I actually done in different areas? Not just the technology areas, it's the industries, the people I've worked with, the types of clients. That's what's key.